Football boots in 2020 are generally all pretty amazing straight out of the box. But what if I told you that you can make them even better?
Because yes, even if you do get one of the best boots out there, such as the Adidas Predator Mutator 20.1 Low, or if you're into laceless boots, the high-end Mutator 20 Pluses, well, there are still a couple of things you can do to your football boots to make them even better than they already are. And here we're talking both in terms of fit and performance, but actually also in terms of how they look, and believe it or not, how they smell. Now, the first thing I want to mention is something a lot of pros do, which is to get special or personally made insoles, which is really good if you have any issues with your feet, if you want arch support, or in general, just want to feel more at home and comfortable in your football boots overall. And what you can do here is one of the two following things. You can go out like the pros and get these orthopedics made, which are really nice, but also cost half an arm to have made. Or you can go out, save a lot of money, and buy these special football insoles, such as the ones from Ortho Movement, which I really like because they're simply more comfortable than the stock insoles you get in normal football boots here, because they give you better shock absorption and cushioning, and they are a little bit thicker. And also they're really nice because if you're like me and you play in a lot of different football boots all the time, you can simply take your own insoles out of the pair you've just worn and slap them into any new pair and still feel as familiarly comfortable and very much at home as you like to do. And another little thing I want to share with you when it comes to insoles is that if you hate your insoles sliding around a little inside of your boots, some people are gonna tell you that no matter if you have your own or the stock insoles, you can use, and get this, deodorant spray to actually make the insoles a bit more sticky. But I have a better solution, and that solution is called GloveGlu. See, this is actually a spray that's designed to give your goalkeeper gloves a little bit more grip, basically. But if you spray this underneath your insole before every use, they're actually gonna live up to, well, the glue part of the name at least, and really keep your insole stuck to the boot so it doesn't move around. If that ain't a life hack, I don't know what is. Secondly, you should totally tune your laces. And yes, I know that if you have a Predator 20 Plus or a boot like that, it can be a little bit difficult because they don't really have any laces. But if you do, use their genius, because laces can actually do a lot of cool things. In particular, hold your foot in place and give you better lockdown. And my best tip here is to use the so-called runner's loop. If you haven't heard what that is before, it's basically that when you lace up your boots and you're at the second to last lace hole, instead of going across the boot like you would do normally, you simply go up to the same lace hole in the same side and you create this little loop. That means that you can then take the end off your lace, you can put it through the loop in the opposite side, and create this little seatbelt-like effect. And that means that when you then pull your laces tight, you push the top part of the ankle down and backwards into the heel counter, giving you a lot better lockdown and a much more secure fit, which in turn improves your performance, and it also helps you in avoiding blisters. So thank you to whichever runner created this loop. And also, of course, if you're the kind of guy who likes to pimp his boots a little bit, you can also simply change the laces, because I think we can all agree that a boot is simply better if it's more you and it follows your style. And I reckon red laces actually looks pretty dope on this. Thirdly, we have the infamous hot water trick, which is a brilliant little shortcut if you want to break your boots in quicker, because maybe you think that the upper is a little too stiff, or you simply need a bit more room for your little toe, and you want the upper to take the shape of your foot a little bit quicker. Now, the thing with this trick is that it's obviously most famous for being used by CR7 back in the days, where the Superfly 2 was stiffer than metal. Thankfully, boots aren't that stiff today, but the thing is that it actually works. So what you should do is to take your boots, soak them in lukewarm water, but it cannot be warmer than you should be able to put your feet in and walk around in them for 20 minutes or so. Can do longer, because the longer you walk around in them, the more it's gonna soften up, the material is gonna become more pliable, and it's also gonna take to the exact shape of your foot. So not only is it gonna make the boot more personal, it's simply also gonna help you break them in faster, which is brilliant. However, one of my favorite tricks when it comes to improving the fit and performance of my boots is socks. Look, a lot of football socks out there, in my opinion, they suck a little bit, pun intended, because a lot of them are really synthetic, maybe slightly cheap feeling, they're very thick, and most of them are also very, very slippery. And in a sport where you change direction all the time, that's not a very good thing. So by simply getting a premium, well-made, comfortable sock with grip elements that grips both your foot inside and the boot, and thus prevents your foot moving a lot inside the boot, well, it's simply gonna make you feel a lot better. And I promise you that if you also fix the insole by using the GloveGlu, nothing is gonna move inside of that boot. And if at the same time you get a grip sock that has a bit of compression to it, like the LightGuard or the Falcon socks, you're gonna feel so much better not only during the match, but also after, because quite simply, compression speeds up the recovery phase, so you're not gonna be as tired the day after. Now finally, we probably all tried having football boots that smell badly. Of course these don't, because they're brand new and frankly they smell really good. Now some people, they don't really care about having football boots that smell bad, and if you're one of those people, you can totally ignore this advice. But what if I told you that you can do two simple steps to combat the bad smell? And the first thing is to stuff your wet boots with newspaper to absorb all the moisture and avoid them getting smelly that way. And then afterwards, using either a bio spray or boot freshener spray, spray it into your boots and eliminate the smell, or simply use a tea bag. You put it into your boots and let it absorb the bad odor. It's cheap, it's really nice, your boots smell better, and they're gonna be better for it. So there you have them, my friends, some of my best tips on how you can make your already awesome football boots even better. And the good thing is that it doesn't really have to be that expensive. I mean, GloveGlu, the runner's loop, hot water, tea bags, grip socks, it's all pretty affordable. So I'm gonna let you try and go do your thing, and I guess you can thank me later. But guys, which is the best tip you have to making your football boots better? You know, sharing is caring, so let us know in the comment section right down below. And then please go make sure to hit that subscribe button with the bell notifications button to see all our latest videos the second they drop. And until we drop the next one, you can go and learn how to improve as a footballer if you click the playlist right down there. With that said, guys, I'm signing off. Cheerio.